Okay, so as you can see here, I want to find the area under this curve from 0 to 4. So away I'm going to go. So let's write this out, what it actually looks like. So I would be going from 0 to 4 of 2t e to the negative t dt. I certainly see a product, so I know I'm going to use integration by parts. So I'm going to try let u equal to t and see if this works. Then du, the derivative of 2t is just 2. Then the other piece becomes v prime. And then when I take the antiderivative, remember that's 1 over the k. Well, the k in this case is negative 1. E to the negative t, or just negative e to the negative t. All right, so now I'm ready to write my uv minus integral of v du. So u is 2t, v is negative e to the negative t, minus the antiderivative of v, which is negative e to the negative t, and then du, which is 2, and then of course dt. All right, so here I go. So let's just throw the negative out front. So 2t e to the negative t. Negative and a negative is going to be a positive. I'm going to bring the 2 out front. And then I'm finding the antiderivative, well, not of the negative, because the negative in the negative I made into a positive. So now I'm finding the antiderivative of e to the negative t, which once again would be negative e to the negative t. So hopefully you got all of those signs, right? Negative and a negative, is that positive? The antiderivative of e to the negative t is negative e to the negative t. All right, and so then I could just write this as, rewrite that, and then write this as a subtraction, 2e to the negative t, and this is what I'm evaluating from 0 to 4. So now I'm to the part doing the fundamental theorem of calculus, the f of b minus f of a. In this case, the b is 4. So I plug in 4 everywhere I see a t times e to the negative 4 minus then my f of a. I plug in a 0 everywhere I see a t, negative 0 minus 2e to the negative 0. All right, and so here I get negative 8e to the negative 4th minus 2e to the negative 4th. This piece becomes 0, right? And then a negative and a negative makes this positive. And then anything to the 0 power is 1, so that would be plus 2. And these are actually like terms, so I could combine them as negative 10e to the negative 4 plus 2, and that would be my final answer. So you see we're doing the same thing with actually finding area. So if I do the last problem, which is an application, says the concentration C in nanograms per milliliter is of the drug in the blood as a function of time t an hour, since the drug was administered, is given by this function. So I know that's going to be my function I'm going to use. And so here is my function, which I can already see that it's a product. And so e to the negative 0.2t dt. And it wants me, it says the bioavailability is found by finding the area under the curve and find it between 0 and 5. So again, I would, let's go up here and get some room. I'd let u equal 15t. du would equal 15, so this is a lot like the last one. My v prime would equal e to the negative 0.2t. And so then V becomes negative 1 over 0.2 E to the negative 0.2 T. So that's my antiderivative, which is the same as negative 5 E to the negative 0.2 T. All right, and so now here, I'm going to start plugging everything in. So my U And then my v, negative 5e to the negative 0.2t, minus the antiderivative of my v, negative 0.2t, and then times my du, which is 15 dt. All right, so I can multiply some stuff out here. So 15 times negative 5, I'm going to get negative 75 t e to the negative 0.2 t. And then a negative and a negative is going to be a positive 75. But notice now when I take the antiderivative of e to the negative 0.2 t, that's a 1 over k, so I'm going to bring the negative 0.2 down, and then e to the negative 0.2 t, and I'm evaluating this from 0 to 5. All right, so if I plug in negative 75, I plug in 5 everywhere I see a t, so I plug in a 5. Let's go ahead and just make this minus 375 if you take 75 divided by 0.2. And then e to the negative 0.2, plug in 5. So that's my f of b. My f of a, I'm going to start plugging in 0. So I have negative 75 times 0, e to the negative 0.2 times 0. Minus 375 e to the negative 0.2 times 0. And if you put all of that in your calculator, you should get 99.1 nanograms. All right, so I would work this out to make sure you can get that answer. But as you can see, these are all the integration by part.